So I have posted new references in our Dayglert 2.0 class. Now, in any platform, no, like this, no, this is our Ubuntu platform. Nagdagdag na siya, no? I'm sorry. Nandito na siya because maybe I have set my settings correctly, but I'm not. Diba dapat? Let me just check. Oh, so it's correct now, no? The DNS in any platform, whether you're in Ubuntu or you're in a Mac OS, no, you should have to set your DNS properly before you can connect to Dayglert, okay? So I have set my, this is how to connect, no? You see, it's much easier here than in Windows 10, no? I'm not sure in Windows 11, no? So it's much easier to configure hardware here, no? And you have a tablet mode. So let's log in. I have looked at some of your exercises, no? I think we should have a deadline by next week, no? As of the moment, I did not give you any deadlines for you to explore. But tomorrow is a holiday, so I hope you could spend time to create your own website. Somebody has made the website in W3 spaces, no? It's a good thing, no? Because it's much easier to write a web page there, okay? And then you can just even migrate it to your GitHub, no? By batch, you migrate everything. It's not recommended that you upload file per file, no? To your GitHub repository. I think it's dilatory. Let's look at the attempt, no? So this is a W3 space. Okay, look at that, no? This one of the themes or templates that you can download from there. Okay, they follow. So W3 spaces ito. And then if you look at the others, most of them are in GitHub. Record ba? Is this recorded? Let's check. Yes, I think, no? So for example, si Dong, no? Has a GitHub website already. This is there's a menu here. This is obviously a bootstrap theme. No, I know it's okay, no? No problem. Let me just check if I have my double check my recording. Yes, it's okay now. Okay, so I highly suggest you fill up the content, no? If you have a personal profile there, you fill up realistic contents, no? There's nothing to be afraid of what you have a Facebook account, you just open it there, no? Diba? You just put everything there. You can add additional content regarding yourself, no? Okay? Or whatever you're doing. Some of you are working already, no? So you can indicate whatever you have there. It's all right, no? Duminisak, let's write. Find out, no? So this is GitHub. GitHub account. Okay. If you view, let's view the page source. So this is a bootstrap theme, obviously, no? Okay, it uses Font Awesome, no, for the icons. Okay, so it's all right. No? It's good that you have picked a good theme, no? So you can still link this to your Facebook and to your Twitter. Okay? Ralph, no? Pwede?
Yes, sir, we'll do. We'll try to push one. Okay.
So we fill this with real contents, no? Remove those unnecessary. Because I suggest you have a theme that has a menu. Because all your assignments will be uploaded here. So you'll have a menu for assignments. Okay? Like, I have let me check one of my classes before, no? Kung saan nila nilagay yung assignments nila. Okay? Let me check. This is like your previous class. We were no longer using Visual Studio Code, but we were using W3 spaces. It's much more convenient. but you can still use, no? Okay. Sino bang magaling dito? Look at this. W3 spaces. So anyway, it's alright, no? So ganito, no? You'll post your assignments there, and then I'm going to check the paid source, and then you're also going to share me the GitHub account, no? You can also share the W3 spaces account, no? Using email. Okay? So, I suggest you create a menu. You create something that has a menu, no? Like this, no? Assignments. You create a portion for assignments because I'm going to check your assignments here, no? I'm not going to run your assignments individually. Okay, from my Visual Studio, that will be too much hassle and time consuming on my part. But anyway, you are going to share me the code because I cannot see everything, especially if you are going to put divide your code into separate files, no? Do you get my point? So I'll give a deadline on this, maybe on Monday next week. Everyone should have a web page, and there should be a portion for uploading assignments. Okay. Any questions so far?
Yes, sir. Just have to clarify with the menu. Is it going to be like a drop down menu, sir?
It's good if you have a drop down menu, no? Like the one I've shown you, no? Mas maganda kung drop down. Anyway, okay. Sorry na. Lagi ito na. It's much easier because it's much easier for me to check if it's a drop-down menu na. So it should be capital. Ay, hindi mo capital because I'm actually doing a remote. No? Magkaiba yung status ng keyboard of the remote machine and my machine. It's like this, no? Drop down. Okay. This is a more elaborate drop down because this is Ajax. But you can use any, no? Do you follow? Okay. This is a W3 template. Okay, from W3 spaces, which I've uploaded to GitHub and get it running normally, no? There's no problem, no? Whether you use a W3 space template or a Bootstrap template and upload it to GitHub, it will work normally because it's the same HTML. Okay, so far there are only 6 submissions. I expect to have all the submissions by Monday next week, no? So I'll give this a deadline later, no? Okay, do you follow? So we are going to do a lot of web development here, so part of it will be writing web pages. You all know how to write HTML, right? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I've checked your, your curriculum. The CS students, second year students, don't have any web development course yet. But I think it's an elective. No? But HTML is public knowledge. If you're in the CS department, HTML is public knowledge, which means that it may not have to be taught to you to be able to use it. Okay? Do you follow? So, you know CSS, right? Everyone? Anyway,
we'll go. Idea, sir.
Okay. Anyway, if it's a small idea, whether small or big, it doesn't matter. We'll do this because we are going to use styling using Bootstrap, no? Bootstrap, and if you have time, we will include a new product called W3 CSS. you know, nowadays, no, W3 schools is competing, no, it's upgrading itself. It's not only competing against GitHub, okay, because you can use it in place of GitHub. It's also competing against Bootstrap. Bootstrap, it's creating its own CSS, no, which is very good. No, it's very competitive. It can be as good as Bootstrap. Have you heard of Bootstrap? Bootstrap CSS and Materialize. These are the style sheets which you can use to style your web page. Okay. If you look at our previous web page, it's very bare, no? There's no styling. Styling is good because we want our web page to look attractive to the users. Who will use an unattractive web page nowadays? Wala, di ba? Dapat maganda, no? Fortunately, no? There's a lot of ways to style your web page. Anyway, let me create W3 spaces because let me do the styling here, no? Before we do that. So, if you want to create a W3 space account, you can just sign up here, no? It's like signing up in GitHub. You sign up with your email. It's all right to use your Ado email. In my case, I've already used my Ado email. So I'm going to use a different email for this demonstration. I-log out ko lang. Because by default, it's already there. Okay. Now, the free, it's not free. No? It's not open source. It's not free. However, it has a free account. No? The free account gives you only one space. Okay? Only one space. Okay. I'm creating a W3 space account. Normal enough. Normal. Nothing to hide, no? So I'll open my email somewhere. Let me minimize this first. I'm opening my email here. Okay. Dito na lang muna i-full screen para I can see people coming in, okay? Yeah, I have an email now. So I have to open my email to confirm the creation of that account. Okay, so I have clicked the link. Okay. Now, you can go to spaces here. Do you follow? Now, there's a lot of tutorials in W3 schools. Everything you need to know. There are free tutorials, no? There are also paid tutorials, however, no? So nandito yung Bootstrap, Bootstrap 3, Bootstrap 5, which may use. We'll be discussing Node.js and React, no? So we'll be visiting this again. So gagamitin natin ito. And then there's, of course, jQuery. There's Git, no? We'll discuss this in the near future. After the styling, no? Our next topic will be jQuery. So we'll be going through this, no? Ang daming lectures dito. So it's a very good resource, no? W3 schools, ayan, no? It has a lot of tutorials. So many things, no? Okay? Do you follow? Very easy to do and very self-fulfilling because it has exercises which you can perform right away from there. In fact, many of the references that I have included in our website, is from here, no? Do you follow? Okay. Let me go back to my, no? So creating an account in W3 Spaces gives you also access to a lot of learning materials, no? So we'll go to Spaces here. This is a very new feature, no? I think just before the pandemic, no? Okay. So this is a free account. You will have one space or one repository, okay? In GitHub, you call it one repository. In W3 Spaces, you say you get it for one, okay? Now, let's create one space. You can start with a template. You can use a blank page, no? When you start with the template, you will be asked to choose. But you can actually also start with a blank page and, okay, choose a template later, okay? What do you call your space? So that will be your, no? That will be your domain name. Okay, so now I have my one space, okay? They follow everyone? No? You cannot create any additional space because this is free. Okay? To look at the space, you have one space here or one repository, you can open it. That's the index.html. No? You can open it using this, no? Show files. So you have an index.html. Now the good thing about W3 schools is, or W3 spaces is, you don't need Visual Studio Code. You just open it here. Do you follow? Okay. We just remove this first. Kasi meron na siyang sariling styles, no? Let's say, welcome to my awesome first website. Ano na lang, no? Okay. And then you just click save. Okay. They follow. And I think we can run. If you run, you'll see the space here. But you can actually go to the actual site. W3, this is the site. So that's the site you have there. Do you follow, everyone? So it's very easy, no? Okay, there's no need to push and commit. So these are your, if you go back, no? If you click save, it's okay. Anyway, no, naka-save na siya. You just go back to files. These are your files, no? Let me remove the unnecessary things. You can create them anyway, no? Blanco pala ito, no? Are they open? Tanggalin lang natin yung content. Okay? Because we are going to create them again. So do you follow everyone? No? You click back to files. This is our files. We have an index.html, which is your default page. And then you have a styles.css and a JavaScript file. Okay. Do you follow? Okay. So let me proceed. No? How do you style your HTML? Magkuha nga tayo ng ano? Definition of biology. Let's make a simple web page. Definition of physics. We'll have definition of chemistry. Okay, we'll have a web page of subjects. Okay, do you follow? We'll create that, no? So to be able to create, to style your HTML, no? You use the style tag. Okay, so ito. The style tag is started with a style command and ended with a style. Okay, do you follow? And inside the style tag are set of rules, no? The rules is a property and value pair. Do you follow? Like a property color, the value red. Another property color and another value red. Do you follow? Okay. So can we have this in our, ano, in our main page? Now the style tag, internal pa ito, no? We can do external CSS, but we'll start with internal CSS, which means that the style sheet is inside the same file of your HTML. Okay. So we'll edit this. Okay. And then inside the head, before the body, we'll copy. And then okay. So let's take a look. Let's run this now. Let's save this first and then see what happens. We say H1. This is a rule which is applied to H1 tag. Do you follow? So let's try this. Oh, nag-red na siya. Do you follow? Did you get my point? No? So the style tag should be in the header. Shall we make it blue? And we make the P red. Okay. We'll save. And then go to our web page and then refresh. Because now it's blue. Do you follow? Okay. Any questions so far? So the style tag is used to indicate the rules that you will use in order to style the succeeding contents of your HTML file. Okay? It's like going into the in a beauty parlor, di ba? When you go to the parlor, you say, what do you want to be done? You want your hair done? You want your fingernails, two nails done, or your fingernails done? Do you follow? So there are rules on how to style fingernails different from styling your hair, from styling your makeup, di ba ganon? Okay? So different rules. A style tag contains the different rules that you want to use to style your HTML. Okay? Di ba? Para makeup artist tayo dito, no? Nagme-makeup tayo ng, I'm sorry, no? You're trying to make up a web page, no? Okay? Do you follow? It's in the style tag. Any questions? No? Now, inside the style tag, you will implement rules. CSS rules and style sheets. Okay? What's a CSS rule? Okay? A CSS rule basically consists of a selector and a declaration. Do you follow? No? So, the first one here, this is the example, H1. H1 is the selector. And a declaration contains two parts, no? A property and a value, okay? So property and value. The selector indicates what's going to be that part in the HTML which will be applied with the rule, which means the color green rule will be applied to H1. Very clear, right? No? So selector and then followed by declaration. The declaration has two parts, property and value. So the declaration is color green will be applied to H1. H1 being the selector. If you say P, small p, this will be applied to paragraphs. Okay? Any questions? No? It applies as a paragraphs. Okay? So madali lang, di ba? Now, let's do that in ano, let's go back one more ano. We will do that in our main page, no? Bakit nag-go off siya? Okay. So let us discuss the selector first. How do we select? The selector is used to choose which part of the HTML is going to be targeted by the styling rule or by the styling declaration that you want applied. Okay? Do you follow? Some elements in your HTML may have a class. Do you follow? A dot selector identifies a class. Do you follow? No? Okay. For example, I can have here in my H1 class. Class is welcome. Bar. Okay. Is that correct? Tama ba ko dito? Kamali yung ating syntax. No? The class attribute. Yan na. Class city. It should be enclosed in parentheses. Okay. And save this. Okay. So, no error. And we say each one is blue. Let's make this red. Save. Find out if it applies. So, an element in your HTML can be identified a class. A class means it's a group. Okay, you can use a class several times so that elements belonging to the same class are actually belonging to the same group. So you can have a welcome bar, you can have a status bar, you can have a left panel, you can have a right panel. No, you can group elements in your HTML. So H1 is a header element, P is a paragraph element. No? Do you follow? Okay. So the dot selector identifies a class. Okay, such that when you say dot welcome bar. Okay. Do you follow? When you say dot welcome bar, color red, color brown tayo. Where will this apply? To all. Shall we say? We'll have another one. P. This is first website. Allow lang tayo. Wala tayong magawa. Allow tayo. No? They follow. And then assign this a class. Okay. Save. Let's try to refresh. Oh, na-brown na siya. Silang dalawa naging brown. Do you follow? Do you follow?
Yes.
Why both? Because they belong to the same class. Okay? They belong to the same class, welcome bar. And when you say dot welcome bar, we are targeting a class, no? The dot is a selector for a class, no? Okay? Can have another ano? Let's have definition of biology. Biology. Okay. Let's have another H1. Biology. Grab a P. And we have an NP. Small P. We follow. Okay. Let's save this. Okay. So those who want to use W3 spaces, this is how you do it, okay? Do you follow? Oh, meron na tayong ano. Okay? Bakit nag-red itong P? Why is P red? Because we have a style P. No? Okay? So, we'll have another style. No? Okay. Subject. Subject, title. Okay? Color, blue. Okay? Subject, title, color, blue. And we'll have this class. Class as subject title. Okay? Tanggalin natin itong P. So we'll not have a problem with that. Okay? And then we'll have a class subject description. Color black. Okay? So this is a welcome bar, no? And then this class, this V1 will say class subject description. You follow? Save this. The attribute is written before the close tag, no? Okay. Let's refresh. Oh, ayan na, no? Biology is blue and black is the subject description. Do you follow? Now we can add more, no? Definition of physics. So we'll have physics. We'll just go to our W3 spaces. We'll have copy this. No, so we can do this also in Visual Studio Code, no? I should like to use GitHub. Let's call this physics. Then let's remove the description. What's the description of physics? The branch of science, blah, blah, blah. Just copy this. Sorry, nangyari. Nakamali ako ng I pressed the wrong key. Okay. And then we should have an NP. So take note, no? We now have two classes, three classes. Welcome bar, subject title, and subject description. Anong nangyari sa aking biology? It's undo. Na-erase. Let's just edit this again. I got saves. I know I made a mistake. So anyway, ayun, biology na. Just copy this. This is just a normal, ano. This is like a normal bakit nagagano na? I want to copy this. Just right click and copy. Sigurado baka hindi nag-work yung control C because I'm doing a remote control of my ano. Okay? A remote control of a remote of my Ubuntu. Physics. Sorry. And then we'll copy the definition. Physics. or you'll have an NP. Okay, we saved. And then try to find out what happens. So take note, no? The subject title have the same properties because they belong to the same class. The subject description also have the same properties because they belong to the same class. Okay? Lagyan natin ng konting ano. Then let's copy this further and we'll include chemistry. So, mas madali ang buhay dito, di ba? Kaysa the Visual Studio Code. No? Because you see, you're doing this online right there and then you get to see the result. No? Wala nang ano, the branch of science. Admit. Okay, so that's the dot selector. What's the dot selector again? Everyone? Okay. What's the dot selector? The dot selector is used to choose a class. No? Do you follow? Okay. The sharp selector is used to choose an ID. Do you follow? Unlike a class, which an ID should only occur once in your element because an ID should be unique. Do you follow? So, for example, we want chemistry to have a different, no? ID. No. We can combine a class and an ID. We'll show that later. No, we'll have an attribute for an ID differently. Okay, let's do that na lang, no? Class subject description ID chemistry. Okay. Want ba o text? Let me find another one. CSS. Yes, test text. Color. Background color. Okay. Hanapin natin ito. Background color is light gray. Okay. At akong ganun, hindi na lang ano, hindi natin ilagay dito ang ID chemistry. We want chemistry to be different from the rest of the class. Something different from the rest of the classes. Okay. So we'll have, and we will target this to the ID chemistry. Okay. You follow? So an ID should be unique, okay? I haven't tried it to be unique, but ideally it should be that way. I haven't tried how what's going to happen if you don't have a unique. O, tingnan mo. Ang chemistry ngayon may background. Do you follow? Do you get my point? Now let's look at the no. Let's look at our. Can you see the no? Let's look at our style. No. Welcome bar is color brown. Subject title is color blue. Now chemistry is also the same subject title of this class because we use the dot selector. The dot selector identifies the subject, rather the class subject title. So chemistry here belongs to the class subject title. But we have another style rule which says star chemistry. When you say a rather sharp chemistry, when you say sharp or hashtag, di ba? Hashtag, ibang tawag dyan? No? We are targeting an ID. Okay? So in this case, the H1 chemistry has two properties to follow. Two property rules to follow. Being an ID chemistry and being a class subject title. So being a subject title, it will have a color blue. And being an ID chemistry, it will have a background light gray. Do you follow? Any questions? Okay, let's have it like this, no? Save. Now, what will happen to this paragraph? The last paragraph. Merong thank you dyan sa baba. Okay? Okay? Okay. CSS text, can we have... text decoration, text alignment. Oh, underline, okay? Underline, okay? So let's have an underline rule. Text decoration, underline, okay? Can we copy this? Okay. Let's have all H1, no? Target natin lahat ng H1. H1. Okay. Text decoration underline. What do we mean by this rule? Since it's not started with a dot or not started with a sharp, it will look for an actual tag. No? So when you say H1, it will look for an actual tag called H1. Do you follow? Okay. So let's start this. Oh, lahat ng H1 naka-underline. Do you understand the concept of selectors now? Any questions so far? So W3 spaces pa tayo ha. I'm not doing it yet in Visual Studio Code because it's much easier here. Okay. So, I think there's an exercise, no? For CSS selectors. So, a dot will target a class, a sharp will target an ID, okay? An actual value like P will target for paragraphs, P.intro, okay? This will target paragraphs with belonging to the class intro. Do you follow? Okay? When you say div P, this will target divisions, the div tags and paragraph tags. Okay? No? Now, there's difference when you say div P. When you say div P, this will select all divs and all P's. When you say div P, this will select all P's inside divs. Do you follow? Okay. Div P. We'll look at parents and children later, no? Div means this will select all elements whose parents are divs. Because it's like also being there. Now, it's also being inside a div. But you can make a graph, no? You can make a tree graph of your HTML. Now, when we say a parent, when a pea is inside a deep somewhere, no? It's one of the children. Div plus P, when the first element P inside the div. P tilde UL. Every UL element preceded by a P. Do you follow? So you look at this, no? Attributes, you can target attributes. Okay. You can target all hrefs, no? You know what an ahref is? You will go through this. This will target href attributes with HTTPS, no? This will target ahref. You know what an anchor tag is, no? An anchor tag is a tag which points to a link. Okay? Okay. P first letter selects the first letter of the paragraph. Okay. P first line selects the first line of the paragraph. The P first type. First, the first paragraph in a div. Do you follow? P first of type. And there are so many, no? So many selectors. So these are the selectors, no? And these are the targeted descriptions. Okay? So you have to be proficient with this, no? How to choose, how to target, and then apply a rule. Okay? Any questions so far? You can look at this page, this example, no? I'm not going to erase this yet. Okay? So that's for CSS selectors, cascading style sheet selectors. Okay, hirap magano. Ang taga, mahirap magsalita na magsalita. Okay. Now, the next in store is you can style a lot of elements, no? You can style. I mean, in fact, we will style until tables, no? No? You can style spans, paragraphs, no? Okay, many others. But the most common is, how do you style text, no? Paragraphs and headings? Do you follow? No? How do we style text? Okay. One is text color. Okay, we already have that, no? And say the rule is, or rather the declaration is, color and the value. Each one is color green, okay? Now, the good thing about W3 schools is you can try it right away, no? For example, ito, pag run mo, ito, this is heading one, which is color. Each one is color green and body is color blue. So, inside the body, it's now blue. But this is heading one, so you can say heading one is color red. Write in W3 schools, okay? Write in W3 schools, you can do that. No, now it becomes red. You can say body of color brown. Okay? So the body becomes brown. Okay? So that's the first property, no? Color. Okay? Background color. Okay? That's another property. The background color, you say background color is what white is useless, you say light gray, no? You can try this yourself, no? You try na lang, no? You run. So this is the body is light gray background. The heading has a black background. Can we do this? Can we use this as blue? And a div. A div is a division, okay? It's like a paragraph, but a div can be subject to more manipulation. No? You can align a div. You can put a div on one side. You know, in Facebook, you all have Facebook accounts, right? Everyone? One post is one div. Okay? So each post belongs to one division. Now, you can manipulate a div better than a paragraph because you can identify its specific location its specific height and width. No? Now this div is used by Facebook, no, to refresh itself. No? You notice that if there are posts coming, different posts coming in Facebook, only those posts with changes will refresh. No? Not all of the page. That's why Facebook is very popular, because it has that technology, no, that refreshes not the whole page. It's very fast because it will only refresh, even in Messenger, no, it will only refresh the part which is updated. Okay, this technology in Facebook is called React.js. We will discuss them in one of our classes, no, how to use React.js to refresh single divs, not whole pages. Okay, so anyway, we have changed the h1 to background color to blue, and then we run this, so now it becomes blue. And the div, we can change the background color to brown. Okay, we run, so it becomes brown. Okay, you don't have to test this in your actual w3 spaces. It's the same result that you get. Okay, so we have text color, which is color, and we have background color. Okay. The next property for text is text alignment. Text alignment. There are three properties, no? Center, left, right. Can we have a justify? Let's have a P, no? Text align. Left. Let's use our P here, no? Text align, no? For P's. Text dash align. Justify. We have that. Let's save this. Para wala pa tayong width, eh, no? How about we'll use the right align? Okay. Let's run this. Oh, nag-right align siya. Do you follow? The default is left align. Okay. So that's text align property. It's either center, left, right. I'm not sure if there's a text align justify. Anyway, can we have a width of the paragraphs? No, nandito ang width. Width. Margins, height and width. Lagyan natin ang width. The width. Dapat 50. Shall we say 200px, okay? Lahat ng paragraphs, no? pixels. Okay. O yan. Do you follow? So width is one of the that you can use to identify the width. Now hindi kasali ito, no? Okay, because it's not a paragraph. Okay? P is not, subject is not a paragraph. But we can use the width of a subject title. Sorry, no. It should not be F12. I'm used to it. Para ano? Yeah. Yes. 300 pixels, no? It depends on the resolution of your screen. Usually, a high definition is up to 720 pixels, okay? So 300. So paragraphs will have a width of 400px. Subject titles will have a width of 300 pixels. So nag 300 pixels ito. Okay, do you follow? And let's try justify for paragraphs, okay? So paragraphs will say text align justify. Okay. Then try to refresh this. O na yan, justified. Parang word, di ba? Do you follow? Any questions? So height and width, no? There's also max width and max height. No? You can identify the, no? So we have the alignment center, left, right, and justify. Do you follow? Okay. We are discussing aligning text, or rather, decorating text. Okay. Rather, styling text. No? Text decoration, no? You can overline, underline, italicize. Okay, let's try this. Can you try this? Italicize. Italics. Is that correct? I'm not sure. H4. Saan ang H4? Underline. Italicize. Ayaw, no? Yan, nag-underline siya. Let me just Google the no? Values for text decoration. Maybe hindi kasali yung ano. Hindi kasali yung italicize. Text decoration line color style. Underline, overline. Walang italicize, no? Okay. We can have overline, underline. Okay. And so on and so forth. Can you have both? No? We'll discuss that later, no? Sigurado kung merong dalawang, ano, there's both, no? Text decoration. So you have underline, overline, line through. Line through is like it's being crossed out, no? Okay. Transformation, no? You can transform to uppercase, lowercase. Okay. You transform to uppercase and capitalize, title case. Okay. When you say capitalize, it's title case where the first letter of every word is capitalized. No? Do you follow? Do you follow? No? That's text transformation. Text spacing. Text indent. No? 5px. 50px. No? 5px lang daw. Let me try it here. So that text indent. Okay. Okay. Refresh. Oh, nag-space. Nag-indent siya. Okay? Do you follow? 5px. That's 5px indentation. Okay? Indent. Ayun na lang, bahala na itong iba ha. Letter spacing in between. If you want it spread out, you want it closer together, you can use letter spacing. You can try it yourself na lang. Line height, no? Okay? P dot small, this is a paragraph with class of small. P dot big, paragraph is car. Okay? Let's run this. P dot big. Mas mataas ang height, line height. Take note, no? The smaller the line height, the closer will be the lines together. Okay. What's the default line height? I think it's 10 or rather 1.0. Okay. Text shadow. Ah, ito, maganda ito. Text shadow. Lagyan natin ng text shadow. Ng ating H1. You can also do this to P. Okay. 2 pixels by 2 pixels, which means that the lower side and the right side will have 2 pixels of text shadow. Yeah, hindi natin makita kasi pangit yung ating background. Okay, may shadow siya. Okay, we follow. Okay, there's also shadow of a box, no? Which we'll discuss later. So this is text shadow. Let's erase this. This doesn't make it better. Okay. So that's all about text. You have text color, text alignment, text decoration, transformation from uppercase to lowercase and capitalize, spacing, no? Indention, letter spacing, line height, and word spacing, by the way, no? My word spacing, you can change the word spacing. Okay, the white space, no? A white space is an empty space. I'm not sure how this works, but you can try this yourself. Okay, any questions so far? Our main source is W3 Schools. So I'm also using W3 spaces here. Tomorrow we'll have no classes. Because it's, what's December 8th? Holy Rosary. It's December 8th. Feast of, this is our Catholic, ano, diba? Immaculate Conception. So yung UIC will have a feast tomorrow, no? Okay. So fonts, ito, no? Kailangan itong fonts. Can you try this yourself, no? Font family. Now you say font family, you can select from a family of fonts. No? It's like this. Now when you say Times New Roman, it looks for the browser. It checks if the browser has Times New Roman. If it has, it will use that font. If it doesn't have, it will use Times. If it doesn't have Times New Roman and Times, it will use Serif. Do you follow? So this is that P1. This is all classes, no? Okay. Because the font is identified by your browser. Okay. Do you follow? So we can use our subject title font. Find out if it will have a different subject title. Ito na. Tinanggal na natin yung shadow. Okay. So is that a different font? You can't recognize, no? Pero it has become thinner. Okay. Fonts. So, Font Web Safe is a group of fonts that are generally inside browsers, no? So ito yung mga font family na font, Tahoma, Verdana, no? These are the web safe H fonts which you can use, no? Arial, Verdana, Helvetica, Tahoma, Trebuchet, Times New Roman. Okay? These are the most common fonts present in different browsers, no? Do you follow? Now what if you don't, if you specify a font that is not supported by the browser, the whole family, it will use the browser default. Usually, I'm not sure what the browser default is, but it will appear. No? Fallbacks are the different fallbacks fonts that will be used the moment your font family is not found. No? It either goes to Serif, Sans Serif, Cursive, Fantasy. No? Yeah, that in that sequence. Okay, font style. Ito yung normalize and italicize. Okay, so we want to italize our p.italic means that all paragraphs with a class of italics. Okay, so we will italicize all our subject title, our subject description na lang, no? Font style, no? That's how to italicize. No? And then to underline text decoration, okay? Oh, nag-italicize. Okay? Do you follow? So you can have normal, italicize, oblique. Font weight. Font weight means how heavy, no? It's like let's make our paragraphs thicker. Kasi masyadong ano. P dot thick means paragraphs which belongs to the class of thick. So you can identify thick paragraphs in your ano. Let's refresh this. Oh, nag becomes thicker. Okay. Font dot weight. Okay. So the different weights are normal, bold. Okay. Font variant of small caps or normal specifies whether or not a text should be displayed in small caps font. Okay. Font size. You do this, no? In terms of pixels, okay. Shall we make our paragraphs bigger? No. Ten yata ang default, no? The default font size is 10. Ah, nagliit, no? Sorry, it's not 10. It may be 20, no? Okay, let's make the font size 30 pixels. Ang laki, sobrang laki naman. But anyway, that illustrates the point. Okay, now what we can do is maybe increase our width, the width of the paragraphs to, shall we say, 800. So we're styling our HTML now. Oh, naglaki na yung paragraphs. Okay. Any questions so far? No? Fonts. Google fonts. Fonts that are available in Google. If you want to use make use of the fonts, you have to attach this in the header. Do you follow? So you can have make use of the this special fonts, no? Ang ganda ng mga fonts, no? Font pairings. Now, font pairings means a combination of the two fonts. Okay? Shall we use this? Tingnan natin yung okay, Verdana and Sans Serif. It's a combination. Let's put it on P. So it's a combination. We'll find out what happens if it's just Verdana and it's just, I'm not sure, no, pero sa tingin ko isa lang ipipick up na dyan. No? Okay. That's Verdana and Sans Serif. Let's go. Okay. Let's just have it. Verdana. Save. And then we'll just open it in a different file, in a different enough. Okay. This is Verdana. And this, that's Verdana Sans Serif. So there's a difference, no? So you combine niya. Let's have a Sans Serif. Let's open it again here. Okay. So this is Sans Serif. That's Verdana. So magkaiba sila ng konti, no? This Verdana and Sans Serif together. Okay. So it's closer to Sans Serif. Okay. Any questions so far? No. So yeah. I'd like you to try, you know, as you create your font pairings. Ayan, no? It's the same thing, no? Shorthand. Now, when you say font shorthand, ang hirap naman itong ano, no? You'll have for fonts alone, for example, okay? Ang dami nitong ano, no? What you can do is apply this, a single font, ano? But what's the, ano? This is the property that stands for, no? When you say font. Una, font style. Then font variant, then font weight, font size, and font family. So for example, you will have first is walang font style, so 20px. This may be the, no. Okay. Font size and family are values that are required. So kailangan talaga dito yung font size and font family, the last two. So this is the last two. Arial Sans Serif and the size is 20 pixels. Do you follow? Okay. You can try it yourself, no? Okay. So instead of using a lot of fonts like what we are doing, we can use the font shorthand. Okay. Where you identify all the properties in sequence, no? So the first is font style, font variant, font weight, font size or line height, and then font family. Okay. Do you follow? Okay. So I think that's up for the moment, no? Next meeting, we will do an external CSS. So, mas madali mag-try, no? Sa W spaces because you get to see it right away. Although you can just, in Visual Studio Code, you can just run it, no? Using live server. Okay. Can you look at these points, these portions? Anyway, these are references from W3 schools. If you want to learn web development from scratch, W3 schools, there's a competitor, no? It's called Tutorials Point. Okay. We have colors, max width, and height. Once na tayo, no? We'll go through colors, widths, backgrounds. Can you go through this for the next meeting? The margins, the padding, and the boxes, no? And then we'll go to external CSS and we will style tables. Okay? Styling tayo ng tables, no? And then hanggang dyan na lang, no? There are many things to style. And we will not finish a whole semester if we will discuss all styles, okay? And then we will discuss bootstrap. Wala pa palang bootstrap dito, no? Bootstrap, and probably we'll also discuss W3. I'm still exploring W3 CSS. Okay? Which may take a long time, no? Kasi ang dami ng, tatlo na sila ngayon, no? There used to be Bootstrap CSS and Materialize CSS. Ngayon, tatlo na sila. Nandun na si W3. Okay? Any questions so far? Okay. So we'll end in 5 minutes. I don't want to introduce any new topic. I'd like you to go through this, no? And test this in your website, no? Okay? Do you follow? So cascading style sheets, selectors, no? So what is a dot selector? A dot selector chooses classes. A sharp selector chooses a particular ID of an element, no? What are elements? Yung H1, P, A, href, these are elements. We will discuss styles for, no, images, no? Because you can make galleries, no, if you like. And styles for link tags, no? Anchor tags, no? And so on and so forth. Any questions so far? No? I'll give you an exercise on this. And maybe, I haven't tried this yet, no? We'll do a formative assessment because there are so many things to be reviewed, okay? Questions? No? So those who want to use W3 spaces, you see how it's done? Okay? You see how it's done? It's much easier. So from time to time, I may shift from W3 spaces into, you know, Visual Studio Code. Okay. Okay. So see you next meeting, everyone. No, if you have no questions. Thank you, no. I'll end the session now. Everyone.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, and goodbye.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye, everyone.